Greetings, fellow Wolfens. Welcome to Tom Clancy's Third Echelon Pandora Tomorrow. This is a brand new series. The game is not brand new, but yeah, the series is brand new. And I've been meaning to play this for the longest time ever, but I was thinking about playing this after I finished Dragapult, but I sort of realized that that game isn't something that you just finish out of the blue. So there's a whole organic process to playing that game. So here we are. We are starting this playthrough now, and let's see how it goes. The first mission should be pretty straightforward, but I'm just gonna go ahead and create a new profile. Of course, we'll be playing on hard. Sorry, normal.
Pandora Tomorrow.
Oh yeah, it always starts with a lock with the minigame. Now, one of the things that I really disliked about...
It wasn't your day. Well, I wasn't very good in simulation.
The NSA just called me. We have a problem in East Timor.
What kind of problem?
A big one. Douglas doing here?
That's exactly what you have to find out, sir.
Yeah, US Embassy to Dili, East Timor. Okay, March 28th, 2006, 1827 hours. Infiltrate the embassy. The Darah Dan Doa, an Indonesian guerrilla group led by Suhadi Sadono, has invaded the U.S. Embassy to Dili to retaliate for the installation of a U.S. military base in Eastern Timor. Okay, the plot seems straightforward thus far, even though Sam doesn't know it yet. We have the benefit of knowing it before he does, so that's that. Apart from that, this first level is mostly a tutorial.
Fishers, welcome back to the front.
I am, of course, using DG Voodoo. And it has been ages since I've played a Splinter Cell game.
Let's work on stealth. Your gun should always be your last resort. Invisibility is your best weapon. We've got a network of photocells on your suit connected to a visibility meter on your OPSAT. They meet us at 3. You're lit up like Times Square.
Not like a Dutch brothel. And I suppose this hint, so to speak, is just... well... just the same thing whatever, you know, Lambert said in just in text form. Or so I would suppose. Right here, there are no enemies. This is like, this entire mission, even though it has challenging bits every now and then, it is mostly a tutorial mission. And that is a thick zip line. More like a pipe, but yeah, you get the point. I really like Sam's suit of this mission, you know. Looks really... cool. Tactical is the word I'm looking for. And this is how you draw your weapon and stuff. Most people already know this, so yeah, there's no real reason to, you know, recap all of this stuff. It's actually quite different in this game how he does it, like he just hangs off the pipe like that. Because in the original Splinter Cell and in, well, Chaos Theory, he actually just uses one hand to draw his gun. Like a sane person, so. Yeah, let's see how it goes, because it has been ages since I last played this game. So, yeah, wish me luck. We also have the optic cable option now in this game, which is, I think, something that was missing from... the first Splinter Cell, if I'm not wrong. I can't remember at this point though. So yeah, it could be that I'm wrong, it could be that, you know, it was there and I just don't remember it. Anyway, these sections are pretty much just... tutorial sections, and right now we don't have to equip the lockpick to use it anymore, so that makes things much easier for us. I'm also using, I do believe I've said this already, but I am using DG Booty 2 in order to render the graphics of this game. That's why the shadows look as stunning as they are, because originally this game does not render well on modern hardware. Being one of the reasons why Ubisoft decided to pull it from the store. Now where do I have to go next? I came up here, but now what? Oh, there. Let me just go ahead and use my optic cable. This room is empty. I just wish there was an option where I could just open the trapdoor instead of directly jumping down.
Before you infiltrate the embassy, let me reintroduce DP Brunton, our interagency consultant. He's got an update for the mission.
I'll keep it brief. I'm sure you know I'm excited to be part of the team. The Joint Chiefs want this mission kept non-lethal and alarms at flat zero. We can't endanger the hostages.
Understood. And with some due respect, leave anything Lambert can say to Lambert. I don't want the voices in my head to become a crowd.
Get inside the embassy. This situation is delicate and largely unknown, so walk softly.
Roger that. And yeah, not a lot of people here either, at this point anyway. Another thing that is unique to this game is how the landmines function. I'm just gonna make a quick save here because I think the landmine section is coming up soon. Even though they do give you fair warning beforehand and tell you to, you know, take it easy, take it slow, I'm still just gonna go ahead and, you know, save there. It never hurts to be safe, you know. So, yeah. And where to from here? I'm guessing up there. So yeah, another thing about this game is how the dogs behave far differently. Like, there are no dogs in Chaos 3, but in the original they would they would like follow you all the way. If they just, you know, as much as caught your scent. But in this game they didn't really do that. They just follow their pre-programmed paths. Can we move, please? Or do I need to stand up? I see. That's making an awful lot of noise, son. Action key to perform a swap to them. Yeah, this is again something that they took away from. Well, the Chaos Theory onwards. Yeah, I don't know why we had to do like a SWAT turn here. Yeah. I will apparently need to shoot out this light here. Let me just go ahead and save here. Even though the game is telling me to do that, I don't exactly feel like doing this right now. I do believe I could have just passed him by without, you know, indulging in violence like this, but yeah, whatever. I do believe they removed Sam's ability to, well, pretty much just kill people in this game while he has them holstered. I do believe I could have just passed him by without having the need to kill him like that, but oh well. And there they are, landmines, which is what we want to be careful of. We want to go under this section here instead of on top. Yeah, we can go on top as well, but it would be better to just go under this thing and well, avoid triggering landmines altogether. More landmines up ahead. And I am assuming that this is the path we have to take anyway. We're just lucky that there aren't any enemies here to look at us, to notice us. Otherwise it could have been like a pretty difficult thing for us to do, whatever we are doing here. Yeah, there's like a fuck ton of landmines here. So I do believe we just need to like shimmy along the edge there. That doesn't really seem to be any other option. Yeah, no enemies to be clear. So Sam is also automatically climbing onto obstacles now, which is like a fresh change of pace. I cannot peek inside this thing, but from the looks of it, there's nothing in there. Yeah, no people to spot us. We should be safe. Coming over here, there are no landmines anymore either. Let me just go ahead and save here. Not that way, I do suppose. We have to go there though, between those two buildings. And yeah, after this, you know, after this brief tutorial-ish section, we begin with the main game. We can perform a wall split jump, but why are we performing it to get up there, right? And right, so it's the opposite side. Yeah, it makes sense. I mean, it'll be logistically easier for us to gain access to the opposite side instead of the same side. Let's see here. since we're walking on wood, might as well walk as if we're walking on eggshells. Even though this level isn't particularly difficult. I mean, I've only played Pandora Tomorrow very few times.
Grim's found you a back door.
Avoid the main gate at all cost. Blueprints show an ornamental stream running beneath the entrance. Looks like a viable way in.
A little wet's better than a little dead. That stream's your way in, even if it means moving slowly to minimize your noise level. Fisher, be careful. This village is a walk in the park compared to what needs to be done inside the embassy.
Roger Lambert. Proceeding with caution. And we're clear here. If I'm not wrong, I think there was a dog there. Or something. There was something there which alerted these guards or triggered them. So binoculars are a wonderful tool for, planning out your motions, basically. I do believe that light can be taken out. If required, that is. I don't think it shall be required this early, but yeah. Yeah, that did not work. The guard decided to, well. Yeah, now we can just keep progressing as we were, you know, without any issues whatsoever. And I think there are some geese up ahead that decided to take flight as soon as we approached them. So, yeah. Just another event that, one of the scripted events that, you know, pulls their attention towards us. Or not. I suppose I'm misremembering parts of this game now. I'll stick as close to the wall as possible. We can move faster at this point. We don't need to be so stealthy as to move this slowly.
The situation is getting worse in the embassy. They seem to be killing hostages now.
I've got a man in my way, Lambert. How flexible is my zero fatality mandate?
As a rock. In fact, we want you to make a new friend. From your onboards, that man looks like one of Sedano's lieutenants. Interrogate him. Find out what he knows about Sedano's defense parameters. The chatter we're sifting sounds bad, but lacks specifics. Details on your OPSAT.
Roger. So, yeah. Let me just go ahead and save here. Because I don't want to hear that again. There's a guy inside as well, and I'm just going to grab this guy, and I'm going to walk back softly into the shadows. Because that's pretty much the only place you can interrogate everybody in the shadows. Apologize if this video might be taking too long because...
I don't speak English.
I'd be willing to bet your neck that you do.
I know a little English.
Good to hear. I'm going in...
They have guns.
I'm shocked and amazed. What else?
My men planted the mines on our way out. We had to escort to defend the village.
Escort who?
Nothing.
Escort who?
Ah! Nobody. I made a mistake.
Escort who?
Ah! I don't know his name. Somebody important to Sedano. He's got an American accent and one of his legs is fake. A bald man with dead eyes.
A fake leg?
Yes. Go ahead and kill me. That's all I know. Go ahead and kill me, that's all I know.
Valum, you there? You have some light? Valum, you hear me?
Well, the good thing is we can stay in the dark for as long as we need to. We don't really, it won't really, you know, do much. So, just one thing that I wanna... Yeah. F1, is it? Yeah, through the embassy, notes. I did not know that. Oh, yeah, there this like map of the entirety of Indonesia. I wonder why. Eastern Timor, that's where East Timor is, apparently. Agent file on East Timor, case file on DP Brunton. Now, I have no idea who these people are, but. Okay. Now, I wonder if there's like a window that I can exploit to get past this guy, I mean. I would hope so. Well, looks like he just head back to his TV show now. No reason for him to be suspicious at all, right? Okay, recover, destroy, security, intelligence.
The flash notes confirmed there was a hostage situation. Indonesian militants.
Yeah, but the hostages are somebody else's game. You're here for information, and especially the information held by Douglas. Shetland's your objective. We need to know how much data was lost.
Burning city, how beautiful. Use of people posts is of course not allowed, and my bullet at my gun is short of 2 bullets. So we need to duck under this guy, otherwise he can like see us pretty easily. I have no idea why, but that's what happens.
Freeze, Fisher. Not a muscle. Sedono is right on top of you. If he sees you, this mission
why
is over.
Why can't we just take a shot at him right
but
now?
But why me? I didn't see anything.
But did you hear something?
No. Just Pandora Tomorrow. And then a lot of gibberish.
Ah.
I couldn't understand any of it.
Give me a bottle.
I... Thank you. Thank you.
Don't shoot! I'm American!
Is Shetland safely separated from the others?
Absolutely. Kim doesn't open the door unless I radio him. We should break his fingers if we want him to talk.
Yes, maybe. But do it quietly. And slowly.
Please don't kill me!
I hope I'm free to move a muscle right now, because... I sort of wanna. I don't know where this guy is aiming or what he's looking at, to be honest. And SWAT roll time. Yeah, I mean, if you think about it realistically, that move is not practical at all. So, yeah. Just hoping that that guy does not see me anymore. Might be safe coming, but yeah. With Pandora Tomorrow, you can never be sure, to be honest. This thing about Ubisoft Shanghai, where they're like super heavy on scripted events, and well, Pandora Tomorrow is no different at all. So yeah.
Talk, damn you! Where is it? I only have to keep you alive. I don't have to keep you comfortable. Don't tempt me. Idiot. Where is the disc? Give it to me.
Time for you to go to sleep, son. Come on. Satchel, I suppose I'm getting a data stick from it. No, 5.72 ammo, even though I'll not be using any of them.
Douglas, it's been a while.
Fisher? My god, man, you're getting old.
You still in one piece?
Where are the rest of the SEALs?
I'm working alone. Haven't been Navy for a decade.
Then who you with?
I'm here on damage control. Just came to smash your computer.
Thank God. Oh, should I say the CIA?
Keep guessing.
I tried to destroy it, but who knows how much data they were able to pull down. I've consulted on security for targets all over the world. Who do you work for? Delta?
No. Staying anonymous.
Uh-huh. Maybe you've got a use for this storage device I pulled off the gorilla I killed.
Thanks. How'd you hide it from your guard?
Just wash your hands when you're done with it.
It was PGP encrypted. Easy stuff.
For all the good it did us, the body text is gibberish. Brunton thinks it's a regional Indonesian dialect. We're looking for a translator.
But we got the sender's alias, Mortified Penguin. And four words in the body text, Redbeard, Saulnier, and Springfield.
My CIA people came through for us. The dialect is Timorese Mambe. There's an agency bureaucrat working in the embassy, an Indonesian linguist, a woman named Carlson.
First name Ingrid. She's being held in a tower off the garden behind the embassy grounds. Grimm's working on a way to contact her without alerting her guard. Carlson's your next objective. Details on your opset.
So yeah, I'm not going to go through all of that text again, being the reason why I decided to save there. Now, I'll be using the optic cable to look through under the door before I decide to open it. And yeah, I think... I don't know whether I want to take out that guard or not. I mean, that would be the responsible thing to do, but... yeah, let me see if there are any other doors in this area. I do not think there are. Is this a door? Yes, this is. This would probably be the better option to take. Better route to take, rather. Because I'm pretty sure that as soon as I open that door, the other door, some people are gonna ask me to come save them. Which I am not gonna do at all. So, I do suppose that guy's gonna keep looking the other way. Very good. Are you... What? Okay, it's just the toilet, nothing else, so I suppose we are sort of stuck here down this road, huh? Okay, and that matters why. I'm just trying to move slowly so as to not make noise. Safe spot for now, I think. I mean, there will be plenty of other forces to take care of the terrorists. The extremists, the rebels, or whatever you would else you would like to call them. And yeah, this I think was a particularly tricky part because of multiple people out here that could you know, spot us. Yeah. I don't even remember where I need to go anymore. I think it was towards a courtyard. I think this is the correct way. But I just can't be sure anymore. That guy's coming over. Which is sort of concerning, because I don't want that guy to coming over this way. Yes. So we are going to need this bottle. And once this guard is on his way, we'll need to toss it before we make a move. Yeah, I did not think that was done properly. Yeah. We just need to wait for this guy to stop looking this way, in this direction. And then we should be able to move, I think. I think I should be able to move now. Yep, probably just a shadow. And I think I'm safe here. I'm just gonna stick around for a while to figure it out, to check whether I'm safe or not. Actually, let me just go ahead and make a separate safe spot right here called Save 1. Yeah, I think I'm safe. So this next part is actually a revolutionary bit of, you know, gameplay, which a lot of people think is specific only to Pandora Tomorrow, but it actually does carry over to, well, Chaos Theory as well, and Double Agent version 2 at that. So yeah. So,
you're not gonna like this.
Chances are.
Security camera tap shows a lone guard overlooking the next courtyard wearing night vision goggles. There's an automated searchlight they haven't shut down. Should be blinding through night goggles.
You're telling me to stay in the light?
I said you wouldn't like it.
So yeah, basically, you know, the fact that you can actually stay in the light and mask your movements by moving with it. This is something that is particularly, I think, is a particularly effective strategy in the bathhouse level of Chaos Theory. Although I have not tested it personally yet. I would love to test it more. One day when I am playing Bathhouse, but until then, yeah, I guess I just have to keep it as a theory, because what happened was I was playing Bathhouse this one time, right, and yes, I was playing Bathhouse this one time, and I was trying to ghost it. Like, when I say ghost, I mean no knockouts, no detections whatsoever. And yeah, I just sort of... That should have been a pretty hard landing, to be honest. But anyway. I just want to talk to you.
Ingrid.
You must be my blind date. I hope the bit with the flashlight helped.
It did, thanks.
I'm doing the best I can. This hasn't turned out to be the desk job I was hired for. I'm a word cruncher.
Word crunching's what I need, look.
Nice PDA. Are you saving up for the color model?
Can you read it?
It's phonetical Mambe. Not a native speaker, but fluent. Gives numbers for a meeting place. 4857 North. 0308 East. 18 hours. The only reference to the location is Solnie. That's not Mambe. It says they're only a few weeks from securing the ingredients for the Springfield demonstration. And that's it. It's signed, Mortified Penguin. Mortified Penguin?
Your guess is as good as mine, but I wouldn't recommend guessing. And while you're at it, forget everything you've seen, heard, and said. Are you going to be all right if I leave here?
Would you stay if I said no?
No.
Well done, Fisher. There's a nice synchronicity between those coordinates and the name Saunier. Both match a cryogenics lab in Paris.
And we just got word from Delta. They're sending their boys in.
Which means you're off the leash. Merry Christmas, Fisher. Shoot all the gorillas you like. You have a quick exit downstairs at the base of the tower. Cohen is waiting for you in the village.
The Osprey can't land in the village. Cohen's afraid of being too good a target. Cut the power from all the spotlights in the village. They'll fly as low as possible to pick you up at the end of the pier.
Was that Grim? Damn. But yeah, what I was saying was, this one section in Bartha's way, you have to defuse bombs, and well, after you defuse second bomb, you just need to like climb back up, and I just sort of, you know, climbed back up at the wrong time, and I entered the light. But what really confused me was how, while I was climbing the wall, when I climbed back up, the person who was wearing night vision goggles couldn't see me because I, even though I was right in front of them, because simply because I was wearing, I was in the light. So yeah. Now, if I remember correctly, this one particular guard is sort of bugged, and we do need to kill him to proceed. I mean, not killing him does not work. So, like, he notices you anytime, regardless of what you, whatever it is that you do. So yeah, or something along those lines. I don't recall what exactly was the problem with this dude. I'll try not killing him, but if required, then yeah, I'll have to put a bullet in him, which I dislike doing personally. I don't like putting a bullet in people. I mean, alternatively, I could just knock him out as well, but... So yeah, this guy, for some reason, he just notices you regardless. Like, it's a bug. There's nothing more to it, so... Yeah, it's better if you just go ahead and take this guy out, instead of having him be a problem later. I do believe this guy's in the shadows. Yes, yes he is. Okay, let's see the game here, because I don't really know about the next guy and whatever he's up to. I do not see any landmines here, but you never know. Well, the guy is looking the other way. I could probably make a break for it, but I think I would rather like to play it a little cool and cautiously, instead of rushing through this level, because that is one sure shot way to get yourself killed. Rushing, I mean. And I do believe I'm making like big mistakes here by quick saving over and over again instead of... Come on. Okay, we seem to be safe here. So I'll just stick to the shadows and make another save here before I decide to make a move. I'll wait for that guy to make another pass because, like I said, it is, cutting it a little close. More close than I would be comfortable with. Okay, time to slowly make our way up these steps, hoping that we'd not alert anybody. And I suppose that is that. Now, one of the biggest differences that you can see between Wilkes and Cohen is that Wilkes actually stood and performed literal shootouts and hot tracks for you, but Cohen literally demands you to just, you know, go ahead and switch off all the lights so that it makes her job more convenient. So yeah, that was a little longer than I had hoped it would be, but then again, giving the benefit of the doubt here, because I'm pretty much just, you know, playing Splinter Cell for a long ass time, so yeah, let's see how this goes. Let's see how this is. U.S. Embassy to Dili, East Timor, March 28, 2006, 2020 in hours, If I'm not wrong, the mission probably started sometime around 1900 hours, or was it 1600? Did it really take like 1 hour or 2 hours? Huh. Mission complete. Intelligence recovered from Shetland's palm top revealed links between a possible enemy agent known only by the emu alias Modified Penguin, a Sonia Laboratories, a cryogenics research lab in Paris. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I mean, the debriefings in Pandora Tomorrow were like pretty concise. So yeah, that was it for today's video. It was more of a, you know, tutorial slash gameplay mission combined. So I'm honestly surprised with myself having, you know, touching Splinter Cell, especially Pandora Tomorrow, for such a long time, and being able to just be so smooth with the stealth with it. So yeah, I honestly surprised myself. So yeah, here's to hoping that we carry on this good luck with the next few videos, and let's hope that the videos come out sooner and sooner. Until then, thank you for tuning in today, thank you for watching, and well, yeah, thank you for, well, watching. Until next time, take care. Farewell, fellow things.